الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تمسك بسنته بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد After praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and sending the salutations upon the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam and upon his family, his companions, and upon all those who follow, upon his guidance into the establishment of the last day. To proceed, ikhwan, فَيَقُولُ الْإِمَامُ الشيخ ibn Baz رحمه الله تعالى. So the great Imam, Sheikh Abdul Aziz ibn Abbas, he continues. قَالَ طيب قَالَ هَذَا هُوَ الْوَاجِبُ عَلَى الْمُسْلِمِ لِقَوْلِ النَّبِيِّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ مَنْ حَلَفَ بِشَيْءٍ دُونَ اللَّهِ فَقَدْ أَشْرَكَ He says, so this is obligatory upon the Muslim, based upon the statement of the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam, as he says, whoever swears by anything besides Allah, has committed a shirk, has committed polytheism. هذا الحديث عند الإمام أحمد وغيره من حديث عبد الله بن عمر. And this hadith is collected by الإمام أحمد and other than him from the hadith of عبد الله بن عمر. وذكرنا لكم يا إخوان أن الحديث عند الإمام أبي داود والترمذي وعبد الرزاق والحاكم وغيرهما وغيرهم وَصَحَّحَهُ عَلَى الْبَانِي فِي السِّلْسِلَةِ الصَّحِيحَةِ And we mentioned previously that this hadith is collected also by the great Imam Abu Dawood, and Imam al-Tirmidhi, and Imam Ahmad, and Imam al-Hakim, and also Imam Abdul Razak in his Musannaf, and has been deemed authentic by the great Imam al-Albani in his authentic compilation or his series of authentic hadith from the Messenger alayhi salatu salam. فبين النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام ها هنا يا إخوان أن المسلم إذا أحلف بغير الله سبحانه وتعالى فهو قد أشرك بالله وهذا شرك وشرك حرام وشرك حرام So the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام here is clarifying يا إخوان that the one who swears by other than Allah that he has ماذا set up rivals and partners with Allah and this is haram and this is وهذا الشرك هو من شرك الأصغر and this type of shirk is from minor shirk فلا يخرج العبد من هذه الملة أو من هذا الملة ولكن هو شرك أصغر هو الشرك أصغر So this type of shirk here is not the major shirk it is not the shirk that removes a person from the foes of Islam but it is minor shirk فالشرك يا إخوان انقسم إلى قسمين. So there are two types of a shirk. القسم الأول الشرك الأكبر والقسم الثاني الشرك الأصغر. As for the first type of shirk, then it is major shirk. And as for the second type of shirk, it is minor shirk. فبالنسبة إلى الشرك الأكبر فهو الشرك الذي يخرج العبد عن ملة الإسلام عن ملة الإسلام. As for the first category of a shirk, major shirk, it is the shirk that removes the person from the folds of al-Islam. وَأَمَّا الشِّرْكُ الْأَصْغَرُ فَلَا يُخْرِجُ الْعَبْدَ مِنَ الْمِلَّةِ وَلَكِنْ عَلَيْهِ أَنْ يَتُوبَ وَأَنْ يَرْجِعَ إِلَى التَّوْحِيدِ But as for the second category of a shirk, it is the category that does not remove the person from the folds of al-Islam, but it's upon the person to repent and beg Allah Ta'ala for forgiveness and return back to التوحيد. قال الإمام رحمه الله تعالى وقال عليه الصلاة والسلام So Imam Ibn Abbas continues He says and the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام also says من كان حالفا فليحلف بالله أو ليصمت من حديث ابن عمر أيضا عند الإمام البخاري ومسلم And the Messenger of Allah also mentions another hadith to show that is upon the Muslim to swear only by Allah. He says that the Messenger of Allah said, whoever swears, then let him swear by Allah or be quiet. Let him swear by Allah or be quiet. from the hadith of Abdullah ibn Umar, also collected by Al-Bukhari and Muslim. Ayu hadithan asah, Abd al-Hakim, which hadith is more authentic? Alladhi 'inda al-Bukhari wa Muslim, walladhi 'inda al-Imam Ahmad. The hadith that's collected by Bukhari and Muslim, or the hadith that's collected by Imam Ahmad?
The one is collected by Bukhari and Muslim.
Nah, الحديث الذي عند البخاري ومسلم يا إخوان هو أصح حديث من صحة الحديث. The hadith that is collected by Bukhari and Muslim is from the most authentic of the hadith. طيب ففي هذا الحديث العظيم أمر النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام بأمرين. So in this hadith here, the first benefit is that the Prophet of Allah is commanding the Muslims with two commandments. الأمر الأول, the first commandment, فَلْيَحْلِفْ بِاللَّهِ. First commandment, let him swear by Allah. Whoever is swearing, فَلْيَحْلِفْ بِاللَّهِ. Let him swear by Allah. وَالْأَمْرُ الثَّانِي أَوْ لِيَصْمُتْ. The second command is, if he does not swear by Allah, then let him be quiet. وَالْفَائِدَةُ الثَّانِيَةُ مِنْ هَذَا الْحَدِيثِ أَهَمِيَةُ اللُّغَةِ الْعَرَبِيَّةِ. The second benefit of this hadith is the virtues of the Arabic language. ففي الإنكليزية لا يرى العبد الأمر. For when you translate the hadith in English, when the person is listening or reading it in English, you don't see the command. Whoever swears, then let him swear by Allah, or then let him be quiet. ولكن في العربية يوجد حرف اللام. واللام هنا من حروف الأمر. من حروف الأمر. But in the Arabic language, this lam, fal, or li, this lam is a lam of command. فبمعنى أن الذي جاء بعد هذه اللام يكون واجبا, meaning whatever's coming after this lam is obligatory. من كان حالفا فل يحلف بالله, أي يجب عليه أن يحلف بالله. So the Prophet is saying here, whoever's swearing, then let him swear by Allah, meaning it's obligatory upon him to swear by Allah. أوليسموت, or let him be quiet. Meaning, then if he does not swear by Allah, it's obligatory upon him to be quiet. فأمر النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام بأمرين في هذا الحديث. So the Prophet here brings two commandments in one hadith. فليحلف بالله والثاني أوليسموت. First commandment, then let him swear by Allah. Meaning, it's obligatory upon him to swear by Allah, and the second commandment, or it's obligatory upon him to be quiet. قال الإمام ابن باز رحمه الله. So the Imam Abdulaziz ibn Baz, he continues. قال فالواجب على كل مسلم ومسلمة الحذر من الحلف بغير الله. He says, so it's obligatory, it's a must, it's binding upon every male Muslim and female Muslim to beware and to be on guard and stay away from not swearing by, or stay away from swearing by other than Allah. وأن تكون إيمانهم كلها وأن تكون إيمانهم كلها بالله وحده سبحانه وتعالى. And that their oaths, all of them, are oaths and swearings by Allah alone, سبحانه وتعالى. قال الإمام شيخ الإسلام محمد بن عبد الوهاب رحمه الله. So the author of the book أصول الثلاثة, the reviver of the Sunnah, شيخ الإسلام محمد بن عبد الوهاب, he continues. قال وقال الشافعي رحمه الله لو ما أنزل الله حجة على خلقي إلا هذه الصورة لكفتهم. He says, in Imam Shafi'i used to say, may Allah have mercy upon him, that if Allah only, or if Allah did not send down as a proof upon his creation except this surah, then this surah would have been sufficient, sufficed for them. قال الإمام ابن باز شرحا. So the Imam ibn Baz continues his explanation. قال الشافعي هو الإمام المشهور أحد الأئمة الكبار. He says, as for الشافعي, he is a famous, well-known imam, one of the elite major scholars of Al-Islam. وأحد الأئمة الأربع, and he's from the four major imams. من هم الأربع؟ Who are the four imams?
الشافعي,
أبو حنيفة,
الإمام أحمد
الإمام أحمد
الإمام مالك
والإمام مالك أحسنت. قال وهو محمد ابن إدريس الشافعي رحمه الله تعالى. So he says he is the Imam Abu Abdullah Muhammad ibn Idris al-Shafi'i. May Allah have mercy upon him. Al-Mawludu sanata 50 wa 100. And he was born in the year 150. He was born in the year 150. Wa tuwfiya sanata 40 wa 200. And he died in the year 204. He was born in the year 150. And he died in the year 204.
It's only 54
years. And how old was he? 54. 54. فمات صغيرا. So he died young, ya ikhwa. Rahimahullah ta'ala. Rahimahullah ta'ala. Qala wa qala al-Bukhari rahimahullah. The Imam continues. Afwan. Qala ibn Abbas rahimahullah ta'ala qabla dhalik. And Sheikh Abdulaziz ibn Abbas continues before that. قال يقول رحمه الله لو ما أنزل الله حجة على خلقي إلا هذه سورة كفتهم. He says, Imam Shafi said, if Allah did not send down as a proof upon His creation besides this surah, it would have been sufficient for them. قال ابن باز وفي رواية. Sheikh ibn Baz says there's another variation of this statement, and the wording is slightly different. قال لو فكر الناس في هذه السورة لكفتهم. It says, if the people only pondered and reflected over this surah, it would have been sufficient for them. قال الشيخ ابن باز, أي لو نظروا فيها وتأملوا فيها كانت كافية في إلزامهم بالحق. الله أكبر. الشيخ ابن باز says, meaning if they only look at what was contained in this surah, and if they only pondered and contemplated and reflected over what was contained in this surah, what this surah entails, then this would have been sufficient for them with regards to them holding on and working by the truth. وَقِيَامِهِمْ بِمَا أَوْجَبَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عَلَيْهِمْ. It would have been enough for them to work by and uphold and carry out what Allah Ta'ala has made obligatory upon them. وَتَرَكَ مَا حَرَّمَهُ عَلَيْهِمْ وَتَرَكُوا مَا حَرَّمَهُ عَلَيْهِمْ. And it will be enough for them to leave off what Allah has made haram for them. لِأَنَّ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى بَيَّنَ أَنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَآمِنُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ وَتَوَاسَوْا بِالْحَقِّ وَتَوَاسَوْا بِالصَّبْرِ هُمُ الرَّابِحُونَ وَهُمْ هُمُ الرَّابِحُونَ وَمَنْ سَوَاهُمْ خَاسِرٌ. He says because Allah had clearly illustrated and mentioned and clarified that those who believe and perform actions of righteousness and exhort one another to truth and exhort one another to patience, that they are the ones who are successful. And besides them, everyone besides them, they are in a state of loss. They are losers. قال بعض العلماء يا إخوان فائدة. Some scholars they mention أن الخسارة أو أن الخسران ينقسم إلى قسمين. That being in a state of loss is of two types. الخسارة في هذه الدنيا والخسارة في الآخرة. The first type is a state of loss that's only connected to this life. And the second is a state of loss connected to this life and the hereafter. ويوجد قسم ثالث. And there's another type. الخسران الذي يتعلق بهذه الدار وبالآخرة سواء. And the third category is a state of loss that's connected to this dunya and the hereafter together. And the person is lost here and he's lost in the hereafter. وربما يظن أن العبد في الخسارة ولكنه لا يكون في الخسارة. And perhaps someone can look at someone else and think he's in a state of loss, but in reality he's not in a state of loss. فبين الله سبحانه وتعالى من هم الرابحون في هذه الدنيا وفي الآخرة وفي الآخرة. But in this surah, Allah Ta'ala is clarifying for us who are the ones who are truly successful. They are the ones, آمن بالله. They believe in Allah. وعملوا الصالحات and perform actions of righteousness وتواصوا بالحق and exhort one another to the truth وتواصوا بالصبر and they exhort one another to patience. فمن هذا نستفيد بأن الكافر الذي قد بلغه الإسلام ورفض الإسلام لا يكون من الرابحين لا في هذه الدنيا ولا في الآخرة. So we benefit from this, that the disbeliever, the one that Islam reached him, he heard about Islam, he learned about Islam, the true version of Islam, and he turned away from it. He rejected it. وَمَاتَ عَلَى غَيْرِ الْإِسْلَامِ And he dies upon other than al-Islam, سَيَكُونُ خَاسِرًا فِي هَذِي الدُّنْيَا وَخَاسِرًا فِي الْآخِرَةِ Then he's in a state of loss in this life and in the hereafter. مَهْمَا كَانَ بَلَغَ مِنَ الْمَالِ ومهما كان بلغ من النساء ومهما كان بلغ من البنيان ومهما كان بلغ من السيارات ومن كذا وكذا فهو في الخسران في هذه الدنيا وفي خسران في الآخرة. No matter how much wealth this non-Muslim has in this life, no matter how many women this non-Muslim has in this life, no matter how much property, how many cars, how many in this dunya, none of that matters. He's still in the state of loss in this life and in the state of loss in the hereafter. وَالْخَسَارَةُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ أَشَدَّ And being in a state of loss in the hereafter is more severe and more intense. فَقَالَ شَيْكِ بْنُ بَازُ رَحِمَهَا اللَّهِ أَلْمَوْلُودُ سَنَةَ خَمْسِينَ وَمِيَةٍ He says, الشافعي was born in the year 150. وَتُوُفِّيَ سَنَةَ أَرْبَعٍ وَمِيَتَيْنِ And he died in the year 204. قال وهذه حجة قائمة على وجوب التواصي والتناصح والإيمان والصبر والصدق. He says, so this surah, Surah Al-Asr, is a proof that is standing as showing that it is obligatory upon the Muslim to encourage one another upon righteousness and encourage one another upon the truth. And to advise one another. And it's obligatory upon the individual that he has belief. And it's obligatory upon the individual that he has patience. And it's obligatory upon the individual that he is truthful. Allahu Akbar. Kullu hadha min Surah Al-Asr. All of that comes from Surah Al-Asr. قَالَ وَأَنَّهُ لَا طَرِيقَ لِسَعَادَتِي وَالرُّبْحِ إِلَّا بِهَذِهِ صِفَاتِ الْأَرْبَعِ And he says that there's no path, Sheikh bin Bas, some beautiful words, mashallah. There's no path that leads to true happiness. There's no path that leads to true happiness and true success in this life and in the hereafter, except by way of these four descriptions. Allahu Akbar. قال إيمان صدق أو إيمان وصدق بال إيمان وصدق بالله ورسوله. He says, having belief and being truthful with regards to Allah and His Messenger. وَعَمَلٌ صَالِحٌ And performing actions of righteousness. وَتَوَاصٍ بِالْحَقِّ And exhorting one another to truth. وَتَوَاصٍ بِالصَّبَرِ And exhorting one another to patience. قَالَ الشَّيْخ شَيْخُ الْإِسْلَامُ مُحَمَّدْ بْنَ عَبْدُ الْوَهَابُ رَحِمَهَا اللَّهِ So the Imam, Shaykh al-Islam, continues. قال وقال البخاري رحمه الله باب العلم قبل القول والعمل. So he says, and in the Sahih of al-Bukhari, he mentions, chapter, knowledge precedes statements and actions. أين توجد أو أين يوجد فقه البخاري? Question, يا إخوان, where is the understanding of Bukhari found? When you look at his Sahih, where do you find the fiqh of al-Bukhari?
In his titles.
Hey, in his tarajim, in his chapter titles. Accent. فَالْبُخَارِي مَا شَرَحَ كِتَابًا مَا For indeed, Bukhari never wrote an explanation of any hadith book. مَا قَامَ بِشَرْحٍ أَوْ بِشَرْحِ أَيِّ كِتَابٍ مِنْ كُتُبِ الْحَدِيثِ Bukhari never explained any particular book. لَا يُوجَد. You don't find it. وَلَكِنْ فِقْهُهُ فِي التَّرَاجِمِ But his understanding comes in the chapter titles. قال البخاري باب العلم قبل القول والعمل. So Bukhari says, chapter, knowledge precedes statements and actions. ثم جاء بالدليل. And then Bukhari رحمه الله إمام قح, a true Imam, Sunni from the Sunnah, Salafi from the methodology of Salafiyya, Imam al-Hadith, Imam of the people of al-Hadith. جاء بقول ثم عقب هذا القول وعقب هذا القول بالدليل. Bukhari mentions a statement from himself. Then after that, he follows it up with some proof. Allahu Akbar. ثم قال والدليل قوله تعالى. Right after that chapter title, Bukhari says, and my proof that knowledge precedes statements and action is the statement of Allah. قال قال الله تعالى. He says, as Allah Ta'ala says, فَعَلَمْ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَاسْتَغْفِرْ لِذَنْبِكِ. He says, Allah says, so know, O Muhammad, that none has the right to be worshipped except Allah. And after that, seek the forgiveness for your sins and the sins of the believing men and the believing women. قال البخاري. Then Bukhari mentions, فَبَدَأَ بِالْعِلْمِ قَبْلَ الْقَوْلِ وَالْعَمَلِ. He says, so thus forth, Allah began with knowledge. Know, O Muhammad, before statement and action. Allah commanded the Prophet to have knowledge first, and then with an action second. فَفَهِمَ الْبُخَارِيُّ رَحِيمُ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى مِنْ هَذِي الْآيَةِ أَنَّ الْعِلْمَ قَبْلَ الْقَوْلِ وَالْعَمَلِ. So from this ayah, Bukhari understood that knowledge what? Precedes statements and action. أين نحن من هذه الآية الوحيدة. Where are we from this one ayah? كم منا يتكلم ويتكلم ما درس شيء. فحرام عليه يتكلم لأن العلم قبل القول والعمل. How many of us haven't studied anything, haven't read anything, haven't said anyone's lessons, never traveled, never sat, never memorized, doesn't know anything, is the main one talking in Islam. The main one. For this one, it's haram for him to talk. Because knowledge precedes what? Statements and actions. فَكَمْ مَنَّ يَعْمَلْ وَيَعْمَلْ بِدُونِ الْعِلْمِ فَالْعَمَلُ لِهَذَا الْعَبْدِ الَّذِي مَا دَرَسَ شَيْءٍ حَرَامٌ لِأَنَّ الْعِلْمَ قَبْلَ الْقَوْلِ وَالْعَمَلِ. And how many of us, no knowledge of anything, never studied nothing, never read anything, never learned anything, never memorized anything, does action, does this, does that. For this one, it's not allowed to do action. Because knowledge precedes statements and actions. Where are we from the likes of this ayah? هذه الآية الوحيدة إذا نفهمها فهما صحيحا سنغير بيوتنا ونغير مجتمعنا ونغير مسجدنا ونغير مدينتنا ونغير بلادنا. This one ayah, if we really understood it correctly, know, O Muhammad, that none has the right to be worshipped except Allah. And now, after that, now, seek the forgiveness of your Lord for your sins and the sins of the believing men and believing women. Now let's proceed. Statements and actions. If we knew this one verse correctly, it would change our households. Now we're not going to speak with no knowledge. We're going to learn and then speak. We're not going to work with no knowledge. We're going to learn and then work by the knowledge that we learn. If we knew this one ayah, it'd change our communities. Knowledge comes before statements and actions. If we understood this one ayah, it's going to change our cities, our masajid. It's even going to change our countries. If we apply this one verse, العلم قبل القول والعمل, then knowledge precedes statements and actions. أين نحن من هذا? Where are we from this here? فهذه الآية تدل على أهمية ووجوب فضل ووجوب طلب العلم أو الإقبال على العلم النافع. So the likes of this ayah shows the virtues and the obligation for the person to seek beneficial knowledge. فعلم. Know, O Muhammad. هذا الأمر الأول, the first commandment. Know. Learn. Have knowledge that none has the right to worship except Allah. والذي جاء بعد هذا الأمر يدل على أهمية العقيدة, أهمية التوحيد. So what comes after this commandment shows the virtues of عقيدة. No, that none has the right to be worshipped except Allah. shows the virtues of التوحيد. واستغفر لذنبك يدل على أهمية الاستغفار والدعاء إلى الله سبحانه وتعالى عمن خاصة. And what comes after that, and seek the forgiveness, shows the virtues of asking Allah for forgiveness generally and specifically, and it shows the virtues of making dua to Allah generally and specifically. قال الشيخ ابن باز رحمه الله البخاري هو أبو عبد الله محمد ابن إسماعيل ابن إبراهيم البخاري. So الشيخ عبد العزيز ابن باز, he says, as for Bukhari, he is Abu Abdullah Muhammad ibn Ismail ibn Ibrahim al-Bukhari. فائدة يا اخوانا, benefit. وهذا مهم لي طالب العلم للحديث. And it's a benefit for the students of knowledge who is trying to learn hadith. ويريد أن يدرس علم الرجال. And he wants to study who is who in the science of hadith. طيب, الشافعي والبخاري لهم نفس الاسم ونفس الكنية. الشافعي and Bukhari, they have the same first name, Muhammad, and they have the same kunya, Abu Abdullah, the father of Abdullah. الشافعي Abu Abdullah, Bukhari Abu Abdullah. Shafi Muhammad, Bukhari Muhammad. فائدة عظيمة. Tremendous benefit, إخوان. طيب, قال الشيخ ابن باز من بخارى في الشرق الأوسط. He says, as for Bukhari, he's from a town called Bukhara, which comes in the Middle East. Bukhara. ولد سنة 94 في آخر القرن الثاني. He says, as for Bukhari, he was born in the year 194. في آخر القرن الثاني, and towards the ending of the second generation. He was born in the year 194. الشافعي was born 150. ومات سنة 56 في وسط القرن الثالث. And he died in the year, in the middle of the third century. He died in the year 256. كان عمره 62 سنة. In his lifespan, his age when he died, he was 62 years old. كذلك صغيرا. He was also young. فحياته كاملة تدل على أهمية سنة النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام. And his whole life pointed to the virtues and the importance of following the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah عليه الصلاة والسلام. وهو صاحب الصحيح, and he is the author of the authentic compilation of the hadith of the Messenger of Allah عليه الصلاة والسلام. وله مؤلفات أخرى عظيمة نافعة رحمه الله, and he has many other great beneficial compilations. May Allah have mercy upon him. يقول باب العلم قبل القول والعمل, and he says, chapter knowledge precedes statements and action. لقوله تعالى, based upon the statement of Allah, فعلم أنه لا إله إلا الله. Know, O Muhammad, that none has the right to be worshipped other than Allah, besides Allah. قال الشيخ ابن باز, فبدأ بالعلم قبل القول والعمل, فالإنسان عليه أن يتعلم أولا. He says, so Allah Ta'ala began with knowledge coming before statement and action. He says, so it's upon the individual to learn first and foremost. قبل أن يقول قولا, before he says any word. قبل ذلك عليه أن يسبق هذا القول العلم. It's upon him that knowledge comes before this statement. وهذا مهم. قبل أن يوافق العبد مع أحد من الناس أو في أي قول من أقوال الناس, أولا عليه أن يسأل نفسه هل هذا يجوز أم لا. Before someone agrees with someone else, or someone hears the opinion of someone else and he takes a position for or against, before that, he has to ask himself firstly, is this allowed? ربما يوافق مع من لا يجوز عليك أن يوافق معه. Perhaps, if knowledge does not precede you here, You may agree with someone that is haram for you to agree with. أو يوافق عن شيء أو مع في شيء لا يجوز لك أن يوافق فيه. Or you may agree with something that is not allowed for you to agree with. وهذا يقع كثيرا 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 جدا. And this happens many times. يسمع شيئا أو العبد يسمع شيئا ثم يقول أو أنا وافقك. How many times a servant hears something and he says, oh, I agree with you on that. أو أنا معك في هذا. I'm with you on that. ثم درس وحفظ وقرأ فيجد أن هذا حرام. أن هذا حرام. Then he studies, reads, does some research, and he realizes that that is not allowed. فقبل كل قول العلم وقبل كل عمل العلم. So before every statement, knowledge has to come first. And before every action, knowledge has to come first. فهذه الآية عظيمة جدا. So this tremendous verse is tremendous in itself. وفهم البخاري بعد أن كتب هذه الآية عظيم أيضا. And what Bukhari understood from this verse is also tremendous. والحمد لله رب العالمين. So we'll take this last part, يا إخوان. قال الشيخ ابن باز ثم يعمل فيتعلم دينه ويعمل على بصيرة والله أعلم. So الشيخ ابن باز concludes and he says, so therefore the person learns first and foremost. Then after learning, he works by the knowledge. And then after him having knowledge, he works by the knowledge. So he learns his religion and he works by the knowledge of his religion upon basira, upon knowledge and certainty. And Allah Ta'ala knows best. فنتوقف إن شاء الله عند هذا الباب. So we'll stop there إن شاء الله. And we'll continue with the next chapter. بإذن الله الرحمن الرحيم. فنسبت فمن الله وان اخطأت من نفسي. Anything that we said that's correct is from Allah. Anything that we said that's incorrect is from ourselves. وجزاكم الله خيرا. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة.